Heath here from PickinLessons.com. In this banjo lesson, we're going to take a look at St. Anne's Rill, a really pretty tune played in the key of D. We're going to play this arrangement out of standard open G tuning. As part of this lesson, we're going to run through both part A and part B nice and slow. We're going to take a look at some technical work which is going to help us play the tune. So we'll have a look at a couple of ways of playing the D major scale in standard G tuning. We'll also have a look at some exercises that will help us play the tune, including triplets, hammer-on pull-offs, and a bar position that we need for the arrangement. And we'll also take a look at a way of backing up the tune. Because we're in the key of D in standard tuning, sometimes the fifth string needs to be avoided in some of our chords when we're playing backup. So we'll take a look at all of these things as part of this lesson. Up first, we're going to take a slow play through part A. 1, 2, 3. So there's the slow play through part A. Take a look at the fingering in both left and right hand as you're working your way through the tune. Okay, so up next we're going to take a look at the D major scale played in the open position. The tune St. Anne's Rill uses some of these scale notes, and understanding where they lie on the banjo neck is really useful for when you're trying to play tunes in D, and in particular while we're working on this one. So let's have a slow play through the D major scale. Open D major scale, one octave. 1, 2, 3, 4. So as you can see, those notes are all found in the open position, starting on string 4. Working our way through to string 1. And so some of those notes are definitely used in the tune. The F sharp there, the low D, the A. Being comfortable with the positioning of those notes down in that open position is going to help when you're playing in the key of D. Spend some time practicing that, get comfortable with it up and down. Definitely going to help with your technique for your right hand, for your left hand, and for also being able to play this tune. All right, so finishing off this first lesson, I'm going to take a look at an exercise helping us to play the triplet hammer on pull off that we find a number of times in part A. First of all, the triplet hammer on pull off, we're going to play three notes, and those three notes are the second fret on string 4, the fourth fret on string 4, and as we hammer on, then pull off, we get our triplet. So if our pulse is 1, 2, 3, 4, triplet, triplet. So we have three notes played in the one beat, so they're quaver triplets. And so to play this and this technique, first of all, when we're hammering on, we need to be quite firm with our third finger as it plants on string 3. So we're going to pluck the second fret, and then we're going to hammer on finger 3 there to the fourth fret. So we can break this down into two parts. We can first of all work on the hammer-on and getting a nice firm placement of that third finger in the hammer-on technique, and make sure you're right across in the fret. Make sure your first finger's right across to the edge of the second fret. It's going to help your third finger. So hammering on, just spend some time on that one first. Make sure you're getting a nice firm placement of the finger, sort of instantly placed to the string. So we can hear the second note sound. The other part of this is the pull off. And so we can practice that separately as well. You can start with finger 3 in place on fret 4, pull off to finger 1 on fret 2. And when we're pulling off, you can go up Or you can go down, whichever's comfortable, you're going to get the same sound. So either flick the finger upwards or flick the finger downwards. But the real key to this is to flick the string. Don't just lift your finger off, flick it. So you're plucking the string with the third finger. So work on the hammer-on. Pluck the string, hammer down the third finger. Work on the pull-off, start with both fingers on, and flick the string back to fret two with finger one there in place. Once you start to get those two, try putting the two together. So hammer on, then pull off. And then the rhythm that we need for those three notes, the three notes need to fall within one beat. So that's the triplet, triplet, triplet. So if you're having trouble with the hammer-on pull-off triplet there, definitely break it down into the smaller sections and work on the individual parts, then bring it together. Sounds great. Take your time with it, give it a go. Head on over to pickinlessons.com. You're gonna find part two and three of this video lesson. We're gonna cover part B of the arrangement. We're also gonna cover how we can back up the tune. The fact that we're in standard tuning and we're playing in the key of D, that can be a little tricky, so we'll talk about that. We'll also take a look at a melodic D major scale. And there are some backing tracks and play along tracks there at three different tempos as well. So head on over to pickinlessons.com and I'll see you there.